take the name Mohammed and you make it, you count the letters of Mohammed, you'll end up with the number 666. Now, the John, the one that was in Batmas, in the thing, he was he had a revelation from God. And in that revelation, it shows he couldn't say Muhammad, but he says his number is 666 for whoever has a mind to understand.
Yeah.
He will understand that his number is 666. Happened to be Muhammad, like the letter M. If you go to any Latin site for numbers, you'll find out that his name is equal to 666, and that's the beast himself that's prophesied in the holy book about him. And that's all what I have to say.
Thank you. The volume is going down.
Thank you. That's very interesting, Sam. Do you have
I want
to
comment.
That?
But how come the volume's going? I couldn't hear him.
I think they cut off.
Oh, that's what it is. Just cut off people. Huh? You think you're on the show? Okay. just let me make one comment. As far as Revelation 13 is concerned and the number of the beast, if you read Revelation to its end, the beast is going to be around when Jesus Christ comes down. If you go to Revelation chapter 19 and you just read the entire chapter, read, if you want to pick it up from verses 11, read to 21. The beast will be around with the false prophet at the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. And it says that when the Lord Jesus Christ, the Word of God, who sits on a white horse and leads the armies of heaven in battle, who has a sword that comes out of his mouth to slay the nations with, he's going to throw the beast and the false prophet alive into the lake of fire, which is the second death. That's Revelation chapter 19, verse 20. So Revelation 13 cannot be a reference to Muhammad, because if Muhammad was that beast spoken of, then Jesus would have already came down, fought him, and thrown him in hell. So I don't believe that if you read Revelation in context, a fair, accurate reading of Revelation, you can't make that identification. Because just read it. Don't stop at Revelation 13. Continue reading Revelation 19. The beast and the false prophet will still be around when the Lord Jesus Christ comes down with the armies of heaven to send them into hell and destroy the nations of the beast to make war against the Lamb. And it says in Revelation 17:14, he defeats them because he's King of Kings, Lord of Lords. Praise his holy name. Now, with that said, again, I don't want to be unnecessarily offensive to Muslims. I have to speak the truth in love. And I know that some of the things I may say will offend Muslims, but I can't help that. I have to be honest to God in Scripture, and I need to please God, not man. With that said, I must say that as far as the Bible is concerned, there'll be many antichrists that will go into the world, and Muhammad is one of them. Now, I know that may sound harsh, but let me read the Scriptures. For again, both Muslims and Christians, if you want to see what the Bible says about this issue, write down the following New Testament reference. 1 John chapter 2, verses 18 to 19. 1 John chapter 2, verses 18 to 19. And 1 John, same epistle, chapter 2, verses 22 to 23. So 1 John 2, 18 to 19. 1 John 2, 22 to 23. Let me read it. Dear children, this is the last hour. Jesus' advent is the beginning of the end. That is, that it starts the beginning of the end and will culminate in his second coming. So this is the last hour. And as you have heard, that the Antichrist is coming. So John believes an Antichrist will come, a final one. But then he says, even now, many Antichrists have come. So although there will be a final manifestation of an Antichrist, until that period, there will be many Antichrists. This is how we know it is the last hour, because many Antichrists have come, which foreshadow the Antichrist to come. They went out from us, but they did not really belong to us. For if they had belonged to us, they would have remained with us. But their going showed that none of them belonged to us. Now, why did I say that Muhammad is one of these Antichrists? We know he's one of the false prophets according to the Bible, God's Word. What do I say he's one of the Antichrists? Because in the same epistle, we are told what an Antichrist is. 1 John chapter 2, verses 22 to 23, we are told what an Antichrist is. So if you want the criterion for an Antichrist, here goes. Who is the liar? It is the man who denies that Jesus is the Christ. Now Muslims say, but we believe Jesus is the Christ, so Muhammad can't be a liar. Wait, let's finish it. Such a man is the Antichrist. He denies the Father and the Son. Who is the Antichrist? The one who denies the Father and the Son. No one who denies the Son has the Father. Whoever acknowledges the Son has the Father also. Muhammad in the Quran says, Allah is the Father to no one. Because Muhammad said the only way he can have a son is if he has a wife and he has sex with her. But since Allah doesn't have a sex and he doesn't have wife, he can't have children. He denied the possibility of God having spiritual children. The only way he can be a child is through sex. And if you want the references to prove that Allah of the Quran is not a father, write down the following references. I won't look at that for the sake of time. Write these down. Chapter 5, verse 18 of the Quran. Chapter 5, verse 18 says, the Jews and Christians told Muhammad that they are the children of Allah, his beloved. And Muhammad says, say, why does he punish you for your sins if you are his children? Nay, you are mortals that he created. So Jews and Christians are not children of God. Chapter 9, verse 30. There is a curse pronounced against the Jews and Christians because the Jews say Ezra is the son of Allah and the Christians say the Messiah is the son of Allah. And it says in this they imitate the saying of the disbelievers of old, how perverse they are. Allah fight them. Allah fight them, how perverse they are. So Jesus is not the son of God. Right? Then write down chapter 19 of the Quran, verses 88 to 93. Chapter 19, verses 88 to 93. It says the highest relationship a person can have with Allah is a slave to master. He is not a father and Jesus is not a son. According to the New Testament, that's the Antichrist. The spirit that inspired Muhammad, produced the Quran, is the spirit of Antichrist, which means that as far as the Bible is concerned, Muhammad is a false prophet and Antichrist. So I believe he is on the testimony of Scripture, but I do not believe he's the beast of Revelation 13. Because if he was, then the Lord Jesus would have came down and sent him alive into hell. That did not happen, which means we have to wait another to come. And Jesus is the sent to destroy him. I hope that answered the question.
Okay, let's take our next call. We have Mona on air with us. Welcome to the show, Mona.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi, Sam. Hi, David.
How are you?
Good, how are you?
Praise the Lord.
I just want to tell you that you guys are doing a great job.
And Lord Jesus.
May the Lord Jesus Christ bless you and lead you and guide you what you're doing. And I'm a Assyrian.
Hey, Assyrian, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Salaam alaikum.
We just want you to know it's okay. It's okay. We will not judge you here.
You know, not only...
Oh, no.
Listen, you're speaking the language of heaven.
Yes, I know. I don't know if I told you, I'm born-again Christian.
Praise the Lord. May the Lord seal you for all eternity. I pray that for you.
Yes, I'm very happy. And you know what? I have a 10-year-old daughter that is dying to talk to you guys.
How old?
Can she talk to you?
Sure. Yeah. Sure.
How old is she?
She's 10 years old.
All right. Lord, bless her and give her life and eternal life.
Can she talk to you?
Of course.
Absolutely.
Okay. Just make sure you make the checks payable to me.
Her name is Miriam.
Miriam, after the Blessed Mother of our Lord.
Yes, exactly. That's why I named her. Hold on.
Hello?
Hi, Miriam.
Hi.
Hi.
Lord bless you, sweetheart.
Good. How are you?
Good. How are you?
Praise God. Praise the Lord. Lord bless you. You have a beautiful voice.
Thank you. You guys are doing a great job.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you for watching, and I pray you keep praying for us to continue to do a great job for Jesus.
I just want to tell you guys that the Muslim religion should be about peace and love, just like Jesus is about peace and love.
Amen. He is. Hallelujah. You're right. Well, pray for the Muslims that they come to know Jesus, because once they know Jesus, they'll be all about peace and love. So pray for them, right?
Yes.
Excellent, because that's what Jesus wants you to do, to pray for them, love them, and share the gospel with them.
Mm-hmm.
And you have a wonderful name. You're named after the greatest woman that our God created, Maryam, the mother of Christ. So honor that name and serve Jesus and love Jesus just like the mother of Christ did, the mother of our Lord, right?
Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you.
Walk proud with that name and honor it for the glory of Jesus. We love you and the Lord loves you.
And let's hope that a Muslim can call in and have as good, as brief, and as concise of an argument as this 10-year-old just called in and had. So thank you for calling. Let's take our next call. We have Yusuf on air with us. Welcome to the show, Yusuf.
Yes. How are you doing, guys?
Hey, Yusuf. How are you, buddy? How are you?
Okay. Thank you. Thank you. You know, you said Islam is a peace, religion, whatever.
What was that? I couldn't hear you.
The Sahaba?
Oh, yeah.
You know the Sahaba?
Yeah, the companions of Muhammad.
Umar got killed. Abu Bakr got killed. Uthman got killed. Hassan ibn Hussein got killed. Ali got killed. What kind of religion is that? Plus,
If Europe ask Muslim people then to go to Arabia Saudia or you change your religion, believe me, 1% is going to go to Saudia, and all of them, they're going to change their religion.